This video is to explain how you can use Amazon's SES service to send emails. An email server's two main functionality is to send emails and to receive the emails. With SES, you can do both, but in this video, we will take a look at using SES to send emails. In order to configure SES to send emails, the foremost requirement is that you should be owning an email ID with which you plan to send emails with. For example, your own Gmail ID, your own Hotmail ID, Yahoo ID, or your own domain's email ID. Remember that you should have access to this email ID and an email client like Gmail or Outlook to view these emails. Now let's take a look at the setup. Assume that a SES user has an AWS account and has full access to use SES service. First step is that the user adds the email ID that he or she wants to use in the SES console. Second step is that the SES first marks this email ID as pending verification and then sends a test email to the email address that is added. The email owner then receives this test email in their inbox. Third step is that the email owner clicks on the verification link in the email, confirming receipt and acknowledging that the email is added in the SES for it to be used as a sender in the AWS. Fourth step is that the SES receives this verification behind the scenes and now marks the email as verified. And the SES user now will be able to use this email ID to send the emails. Now let's take a look at a demo of this process. This demo is to show how you can use AWS's SES service to send email using your own email ID. For this demo purposes, I'm using contact@gentrylearning.com, which is a verified email address in my account. So I have written a small Python program and my PyCharm is already connected to my AWS console, to my AWS account. So this Python program is using the MIME, the email.mime.multipart libraries, and here I'm setting up the email details here. The subject of the email is test email, and the email ID I'm using is the contact@gentrylearning.com, which is a verified email ID in my account, and I'm sending it to my own personal email ID, the body of the message, and which is attached as a MIME text. And the reply to can be any email that doesn't need to be an email that is like verified, using which the receiver of this email can actually reply to. And I'm using the Boto3's client SES, the SES libraries. The send raw email is the functionality that I'm using to send this email. So let me run this program first. And before that, I can show in my personal email that there is no emails currently. And after I run this program, you will receive an email here. So I've executed the program and it has sent successfully. It has sent an email successfully. So going back to my email address here, so you notice that this is a new email I have received. Here is the message that I typed in the program, and examining the content here. So the reply to is gentrylearning@gmail.com, and the email ID, received email ID is this. You notice that it is actually emailed from amazonses.com and the subject is test email. So all the content that I have got in my PyCharm program is here. So now, if I change this email address to an email ID which is not verified, so the gentrylearning@gmail.com is not verified, so if I run this program, I'll be getting an error. So notice that it says like email address is not verified, the following identities failed the check in the US East 1 region. So I'll go back to my SES console. I'll go ahead and delete this email and go back to my SES console. And now I'm going to add this new email ID. So this is just a message that you will be sent a verification email. So I'll go ahead and close this here. And notice that the verification status currently says this pending verification. So if I go to my gentrylearning@gmail.com email, so notice that I received a email, like a verification email from AWS. So I will go ahead and click on this email. So it is being verified right now. If I go back to my console, so this pending verification would actually change to verified. If I refresh the screen, so notice that it is being verified currently. So if I go back to my program, now I'll execute the program. Notice that I am able to send email using gen3learning@gmail.com, which is a new email that I added and verified. So going back to my email address here, so see that it is actually received. So it's the same message and the from to everything is the same here. So that's all for the demo. Thank you. Now that you have learned to set SES to send emails and took a look at the demo, let's take a quick look at how you can use the sendemail.py program that we saw in the demo in your use case. You can code this sendemail.py directly in your Lambda and trigger the Lambda based on CloudWatch or other triggers. You can also have this program run in your EC2 instance or in your EMR cluster. When you use it in your EC2 instance, you will have a separate trigger to initiate the program to be run. Within your EMR, you can add this program to be executed as a step in your OOSI workflow. In the next video, we can take a look at how you can use SES to receive email and then configure an email client for you to view the email received in SES. Hope this video helps you to understand how to use SES to send emails and you can apply this knowledge in your work. If you have any questions on this video, please email contact@gen3learning.com. Thank you.